set the tone, and it's got that musical background, meter built right in, so it should make us just settle in and be ready for an afternoon. And then Mrs. Doug has a message for us as well. You probably all know that Mrs. Doug has moved to Colorado, so she has recorded a message for us that we'll listen to shortly. The hymn I chose to set the tone this afternoon is from the Redeemer section of our hymn. It's in 514, You Are the Way, and includes an Easter message in it as well, which is something that should be fresh on our minds. So we begin it. You are the way. Through you alone can we the Father find. In you, O Christ, has God revealed his heart and will. You are the truth, your word alone true wisdom can impart. You only can inform the mind and purify the heart. You are the life, the empty tomb proclaims the conquering heart. And those who put your trust in you, not death nor hell, shall come. You are the way, the truth, the life. Grant us that way. Today, and Mrs. Dunn's message?
At the end.
At the end. Very good. So then we'll turn it over to Colton. I guess he's going to introduce his first piece.
Hi, I'm Colton McGee, and my first song will be Boulevard of Broken Dreams. It is by Green Day, and the lead singer is Billy Joel. And the song is about his unfulfilled dreams and his loneliness. The lead singer was inspired in it by a photo of an actor walking across New York alone. And with the music, it's full of slow chords and very steady beat to show the loneliness he has.
Thank you.
Entertainment by Francesco Carino is based on the song from Linus. Linus is a rock, also known as. I Dream a Dream. Here, the desperate character, Francine, reflects on how, when she was young, she had a dream that her life would be full of love and contentment and be worth living, and now how broken and hopeless her life is now. How that dream was shattered by the cruelties and harshness of her life. I love the emotion and feeling of the song, expressed by the exaggerated ricercandos, dynamics, runs, broken major and minor chords, and the other beautiful musical components. It all captures and adds to the lovely hope she once had, and also to the despair and grief that she has.
Thank you.
Through my own life, my dreams have changed. They've ebbed and flowed with age and knowledge. From the littlest dream of wanting to be a princess to the more recent dreams of wanting to major in math and music. In this piece, listen for the ebb and flow of a familiar melody throughout. The dynamics may change, but the melody stays consistent, just like the dream.
Thank you. Thank you. It was working before, honestly. So I appreciate your patience.
Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for coming to our recital this afternoon. This has been quite a year filled with some very ambitious students. Colton has done a great job at advancing his skill set, including improving upon his syncopation. Both Ava and Allison have served not only as musicians and accompanists for both our Christmas and sacred concert here at CLHS, but also in their home congregations playing for entire church services. It is my ultimate source of pride and heartfelt joy when my students use their gifts to glorify God. And both of these talented young ladies have taken on the extra task of juggling their school schedules and extracurriculars, but not forgetting to serve their Savior with the gifts they've been given. They also served as judges for our first ever peer review with our Concord Lutheran Academy piano students. It was wonderful to see their professionalism in helping encourage and give constructive feedback to our younger pianists. Every year at our end of year recital, I like to take time to acknowledge our senior students leaving us. So, Ava, would you like to come forward? This year in particular is very special and simultaneously a somber moment for me. Aside from my own children, Ava is the longest running piano student I've had the pleasure of teaching. Ava has taken lessons with me since she was in the first grade, and I've had the amazing opportunity of watching so many children's faces and posture over the years as they concentrate, as they can play their little pieces so well. And I can still picture Ava's face, and it is still the same determined look today that it was back then. A lot of people will look at Ava and listen to her play and simply marvel at her talent and ooh and ah at how well she plays. But it hasn't always been an easy journey. Ava and I actually just discussed this week about how the path to success is not always a straight path, and it does not always have an upward trajectory. And people don't always see our challenges. They see the result of how we handle those challenges. From years of practicing through the boring necessary songs and completing theory that nobody likes to learn, to dealing with the passing of her mother at a young age and having to grow up quicker than others around her, to participating in high school sports and suffering concussions that took her out of the musical game for a while, to continuing to accept every musical challenge I throw at her and finding herself in a mental game against herself. I appreciate that Ava and I were able to be on this journey together for so long. We were able to create a bond where I knew her well enough to know how hard I could push her and when to back off. And she trusted me that even if something seemed insurmountable, I would not give her something that I didn't believe she could achieve. And for all those times she had a hard time believing in herself, I would remind her that I could believe in her enough for both of us until she found that belief for herself again. The one thing I can absolutely say is that she has more perseverance and fortitude than any other student I've had the pleasure to teach. And I'm just so proud that she has given me the opportunity to be on this journey with her. She puts her heart and hard work into her music more than anyone I know. And I'm so excited to see how God is going to use her in the future. Ava, I love you, and I'm so incredibly proud of you, and I will absolutely miss being able to work with you. May God bless your future endeavors. Thank you so much, everyone, again, for coming to our recital. Please feel free to take pictures of the students at the piano and enjoy some refreshments and the rest of your afternoon.